Recently, we had many shocking news locally and internationally. Which one do you concern most? Why?
I work in a TV news station. My job is to report all sorts of news events. So tell me about international and local news. And recently, we know that the Boston bombings claimed so many victims. And one of the victims is me. Because I work at 5 for the international news. When there is a breaking news, I have to report it immediately. And when there is new update, I have to write about it. I was overwhelmed by all the details. And what struck me the most is that there is nothing we can prepare. How can you imagine that people go to a marathon to enjoy life, ran into such a misfortune? So I remember when the Boston bombing happened, the day, that afternoon after my work, I gave my mother a call. I told her, Mom, I'm sorry. I've been so bad to you, almost like a bomb. But from today on, I'll be nice to you. I'll call you every day. Be like a good daughter. And the thing is, when you see so many misfortunes or misfortunate news, either locally or internationally, you want to think that if we cannot prepare for the unpredictable life, what can we do? And I think the best thing to do is to live for the moment to the fullest. So even when we watch news, we feel bad because there is bombings and there are unpredictable things, but there is one thing we can control, that is to live our life to the fullest and live it well. Contest master.
Recently, we have had shocking news. Bombs in America, and my condolences to all the victims, and a bomb scare on the high-speed rail in Taiwan. And I think because Taiwan is so close to home, that one scares me a little bit more because Taiwan is my home. I've lived here for 12 years and I consider myself half Taiwanese. I might not look Taiwanese, but I actually am deep down inside. I'm Taiwanese. And to those people who put those homemade bombs on that train, I want to say, you don't come here and screw around with my country. I won't stand for that. My dad told me there are three things that we all have in common. We might be from different nationalities. I might not have been born here, but we have three things in common: community, family, and friendship. And there's one thing that binds us together and that we thrive on, that binds us together with those three things. We thrive with one thing that we never have enough of, and that is time. And if somebody plants a bomb that takes away friends, family, or community, they take away time from us that we can never have back. They take away something that is ours, our loved ones. They take away something from our hearts. They tear away the fabric from our society. And I want to say to them, we will not stand for it. And I'm so happy that the people who was responsible for that got apprehended so soon by the police. In Taiwan, first of all, I want to congratulate the police. And in America, I take my hat off to those people. Within, I think, 80 hours, they fought them, they caught them, and they are going to bring them to justice. Thank you to everybody who fight for justice. Contest master.
I have one confession to make. I don't really watch news. So, not regularly, but I do watch some read magazine, some TV with my kids, some TV television program I watch like on to on basis. But one thing that caught my attention is lately I realized that there are a lot of news about kids being kidnapped and also may bombing and damage our society. That's scary to me. Why? Because I have two lovely daughters. I had to think about their safety. So what disturbing me the most and what concerns me the most is the safety of our kids in the society, regardless it's local or internationally. So talking about children's safety, I think this is something that's quite disturbing, that it always ends on the news. And when I watch every day, I want to shut down the TV. Why? Because my girls are asking me, why, mommy, why? So cruel, so scary, shut it down. But I told my daughters, don't be concerned, mommy will protect you. And I'll tell my daughters what to do to protect ourselves. Memorize my mobile number, 1921-820-017. They memorize by heart and memorize my name to say how to protect themselves. And that's what I told them. That's what I concerned the most. And I called the teacher, said, you have to tell the kids they have to learn how to protect themselves, because that's the main key issue we need to concern as parents, as kids, as teacher, as every one of you. How many people have kids? Raise your hands. Many. Do you guys concern your kids' life? Are you concerned? Are you concerned the society, the bombing and the kidnapping, or you know, some kids got their hairs got cut off and trying to pretend a boy? So this is a scary news that I would not want to see in our life. In conclusion, this kind of news is scary, and we have to protect ourselves. And remember, you know, society needs safety.